Welcome to Michael Tingsager, who is the founder of Bear Kitchen and Hospitality Mavericks, to the Hospitality Talks podcast stroke vlog. Thank you so much for joining me. You were recommended by a good friend of ours, Kieran, and it would be great if you would just tell anybody that's out there watching who maybe doesn't know who you are and what you do exactly that.
Thank you very much, Katie, for having me on the podcast. Yeah, but I'm involved in Hospitality Mavericks with podcast and consultant to business to try to help and leverage the potential of hospitality business, especially leaders within them. For this podcast, we're talking about the Bear Kitchen, where I'm the co-founder with my other co-founder, Intangible, which is a business in essence is trying to change the world by the way we eat. And we're doing that by learning people to eat like bears. And bears, they eat primarily plant-based food, surprising to many, and maybe coincidental. And when they have a hiker coming by, they have a bit of meat. But normally they will eat plant-based if there's not, of course, a polar bear, somebody would debate with me. And then when they get meat, again, they also go a bit higher in the food chain. They will never eat processed and factory farm meat. And we build a business on the back of that philosophy and the purpose on to change the world by the way we eat. And we had ended up with a model before all this happened, the big crash and the bang, like anyone else, to serve offices around London, especially East London. So some of our clients was Airbnb to serve their employees twice a week without food, where we had like a transformative meal, or they have a lunch where they not only got food but also got some really, really good food that was good for them and the planet, and they got a conversation around food, and strange things happen around the meal. The meal is an inflection point of many great things in the world. And of course, like anyone else, we are now in this process of reinventing ourselves during the crisis, but our purpose hasn't changed. We're still in the world by changing the way we eat with the Bear Kitchen philosophy. So yeah.
Thank you. Michael, what, you know, looking at that philosophy, obviously, you must have been hit pretty hard when the coronavirus situation first reared its ugly head. What were the initial impacts for you guys?
It took about 2 days to, you know, it's a bit like looking at share price. I think many have described in that, like you just saw it drop, you know, the client started to, you know, we're not having this meeting next week, or we're not having lunch this week. You saw them one by one dropping off by within 2 days, all orders we had booked in for 2 months was canceled. So, you know, all revenue disappeared. And as any food and restaurant and hospitality business, it's a cash business. And it made us, you know, it made us a shock, but quite quickly, I think we in our head got it turned around. What is the opportunity within that? And of course, we've been looking at, like anyone else, how can we restrain cash, make deals with our suppliers and all the traditional business thing. But the main thing was also that how are we going to be on top of the wave instead of under the wave, no matter how long this is going to take. But we started very quickly to say that to ourselves, we have a book of behaviors and beliefs we've done with our employees, and this is how we conduct things in the business. And one of the beliefs in there is do the right thing. And it was one of the guys said in a wider team meeting with 10 people on that call, said, what are the right thing we're going to do right now? We discussed that, and we decided that our first initial focus was to help people, you know, that needed food and couldn't get access to great food that really boosts their immune system and energy. And then we came down to the NSS, and then we started supplying food into hospitals. We've done a little fundraise ourselves where we have raised some money now, and it's totally, you know, zero profit game. It's just about bringing food into these doctors and nurses, mm-hmm. so they actually can, you know, get some proper food when they have to save life on the front line. And we're going to continue doing that. And then, you know, we're also looking at a number of other ways to create new revenue streams in this, because we need to, because we don't know when this is going to end, and we don't know if this is it, or we're going to bunch out in and out of lockdown. Are we slowly going to open? So we've been forced really to think fast and working on 5 different revenue models right now to be in a better place, mm-hmm. on the other side of this. So we are trying to take the positive spin of it. But again, I understand it's catastrophe, and we are as under pressure as many are anyone else. We haven't found the golden rule out of this. Yes.
No. I'm not sure anybody's found the golden route out of it. I think that most people are just trying to cope as best they can by bringing in a revenue stream and as you say, keeping people in jobs and also doing something to help. So I guess having those strict philosophies of conduct, if you like, for Bear Kitchen has helped you in this situation, because actually, you know, we keep saying over and over again that businesses will be judged ultimately by how they behave in this particular crisis that we're in. So essentially Bear Kitchen is incredibly well placed to do the right thing and to make sure that you are continuing to look after the people that work for you, but also looking after those people in the NHS on the front line. Do you think that this will fundamentally change how your business continues from here on in?
It's funny, we had that conversation this morning on our investor, we call it our board meeting, and in a way we haven't really repositioned the way we do business, because our principles are principles around food, the way we conduct ourselves around our staff. Like I said, do the right thing. We have another value that's called respect, which sometimes when you're under pressure, you can, you know, almost times you can get that you need to respect, to listen to other and stuff like that. So we talked about these things. I think it's going to transform our business in the way if we survive this, we will as a team never be stronger, and we will be as business not more relevant than ever, because we all know that, you know, what's happened here comes from, you know, squeezing the planet and our food chains and our supply chains harder than we need to. And Mother Earth has given us a warning. So we think that if we can survive this, we will have the opportunity from a business point of view of our lifetime if we can execute and fulfill that. And that's the whole team looking at that. But there is an interim where, of course, you have to survive, and that will transform your business, I think. I think there are many businesses that come out of this, of the restaurants or any other business, they will have created revenue streams they've been thinking about for years in no time.
Yeah.
So innovation, it's good for innovation. But, it's definitely hard work for your mental health. I think that's probably my biggest concern, that we will, you know, what how can we make our people feel mentally safe with this? Because it's not only at work, it's like everything is thrown up in the air. I've been like, there's so many, the whole, you know, we have the wheel of life, you know, all those elements are thrown up in the air. And how do we actually, as a business owner, leader, how do you make sure that your own and your people's wheel of life is somehow balanced in that? I think that's probably the biggest concern in this transformation. The business, yeah, will change, but fundamentally how we do things, I think it's just going to be scaled up in a way.
Thank you, Michael. One last question before I go. When we're talking about the new normal, it's very easy to think about what's immediately in front of us. So what is my business doing? What about my people? What about the people that I'm serving in the NHS? What, you know, i.e. the people that you're having these constant touch points with. What about the average consumer? What do you see as being the new normal for the average consumer that may be used to just visit the hospitality sector in a normal way? What, you know, what's your, and again, no one's got a crystal ball, but what's your opinion on what that might look like?
I think they will return, but they will return with different demands, and they will want to have, you know, transparency.
Yes.
They can understand where, how you treat your supply chain. They want to understand what you do to make sure you take care of your people, and there will be a much bigger difference between, you know, there will be a list. I say, I've talked a lot about, there's a list where there's, you mentioned a bit, some, there will be some companies on, they're absolutely awesome, amazing lists, and then there will be, you know, I probably don't want to be a customer there, and I probably don't want to be an employee there. And that's not, it goes for all businesses, and you've seen examples of that across sectors about how they behave. And I think people, of course, going to be, people talking about, people going to have less money, therefore they're going to spend them more with care. They're going to spend them to take the restaurant sector. The food dollar could be spent with care. So what you do now and how you behave consistently, I think, is going to be very important. I think that's one of the main things. And I think they, again, you know, all the other trends around plant-based food and stuff like that, if you go technical down it, will just explode. Mm-hmm. But also the provenance of where that food is from and the authenticness of that. You can't get a, I don't think, I don't think you're going to get far about, you can always be exposed, but I think it's going to escalate in a time where people want honesty and trust, because we're in the bottom of the Maslow hierarchy of needs. We need to build all that trust up again. It's not about self-actualization. It's about making my family, if you say, eat well, keep my health, and these kind of things. So yeah, I don't know if that answered your question, but that was my initial thoughts.
I think you're absolutely right. I think that honesty, transparency, authenticity, yeah. I think that all of these things that possibly some marketers might have seen as maybe buzzwords previously, I think now they're going to become even more important. So brilliant. Michael Tingsager, thank you so much for your time on Hospitality Talks. It's been really lovely having you on. It's been great to hear your viewpoint, and I wish you the best of luck with Bear Kitchen and all of your other endeavours.
Thank you very much, Katie, and good luck to you as well up there.
Thank you, Michael.